You'd probably never guess it, but I'm using somewhere around a $25 to $30 webcam and its onboard microphone right now to film and record the audio of what you're listening to. So I'm going to show you three tools that are free that you can use right now to improve that, make it a 4K 60 video with podcast quality audio. Let's go. All right, so you're probably wondering, what free tools are you using then, Jeremy? Well, the different tools I'm using first are Adobe Podcast to get this audio quality that you're hearing right now. I'm also using something called Video2X that you can get for free on GitHub that will improve resolution from 1080p to 4K. And I'm using something called Flowframes that will actually improve the frame rate from 30 frames per second to 60 frames per second for nice fluid motion. So you can use all these different tools together and chain them together. And I'm going to walk through each one of those, starting with the audio chain. So before we get started with processing our video, we're going to show you a starting point, which is untreated in terms of video as well as audio. This is 1920 by 1080 at 30 frames per second. Okay, so this is the video I'm going to use in terms of a control video. So you can hear it first natively from the webcam, the Lenovo Essential FHD webcam, and then I'm going to apply the different layers for audio on top of it, and I'm going to also apply the layer of video resolution and then another layer in the chain for video frame rate. In step one, we'll only process the audio with Adobe Podcast. The video is untreated at 1080p 30. So for the audio, you're going to want to go to podcast.adobe.com and sign up for an account on Adobe. That's going to give you a beta trial license, essentially, to be able to use the podcast audio. Now, it's going to require that you upload an MP3 file in order to convert that into the cleaner podcast level audio. So I personally use Techsmith Camtasia to record and edit my videos. That means it only outputs something called an M4A file, so I've got to run that through a conversion using VLC Media Player to get that to MP3. Then once you upload that, it will take a few minutes and basically convert that audio to cleaner podcast level audio. For step two, in addition to the Adobe Podcast treatment, we'll also upscale the video to 4K using Video2X. Now, the next thing that you're going to need to do is update or upgrade the resolution of your video. Now, for that, on the link on the screen is a link for GitHub and where you're going to go to get Video2X. Now, Video2X is basically an upscaler that will take videos of all different sizes and can upscale them, 2X in our case. So it's going to start out at 1080p or 1920 by 1080, and it's going to convert that to 3840 by 2160. Now, depending on the length of your video, this can take hours, it can take days, depending on how long your video is and the system specs that you have running it. So you're going to want to create your video, then run it through this tool, and you'll be able to have a nicer resolution at 4K. Okay, so step three is our final step. We've already processed the audio, we've already upscaled it to 4K. Now we're going to change it from 30 frames per second in order to make it to 60 frames per second to smooth out the motion and the movement. Now the next thing we need to do is actually bump up the frame rate, because this camera that I'm using right now is limited to 30 frames per second. So what I'm going to do is actually use a tool that's called Flowframes, and I'm going to take the 30 frames per second video and move that to 60 frames per second. So I'm actually chaining in the video that I had with the Video2X, and that's at 30 frames. And then once this is done, this will also take quite a long time, depending on the length of your video. That will actually interpolate all the different frames between those 30 to 60 frames and smooth out video motion that you've got as part of your content. Those are the different tools that we're going to use in the tool chain. First, Adobe Podcast, then we're using Video2X, then Flowframes. And now you can make your content that much better from a quality perspective. It's not going to solve all problems. You still have to build amazing content, but you can see that with some free tools and some extra time in terms of using AI processing, you're able to get amazing results. I want to thank everybody who's created these different software tools, donate to things like Flowframes as part of monetization model. And if you like this tip, be sure to give me a like, otherwise subscribe to my channel. And for more tips like this, including how to demonstrate on Windows, also for how to build the best possible live streams and work from home, and even some hardware and gadget reviews, subscribe to my channel, and thank you as always for watching.